Hi, Consigli.
Now, in the yesterday's class, we studied about multiplication and multiplication of the large numbers and lattice multiplication. About all these, yesterday we discussed. Now, today in this class, we are going to study about the division. About the division, already you have an idea. That means dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. That is the division rule. You have an idea about the division problems. Using that knowledge, now we are going to learn about the properties of division. In the division, some properties are there. About these properties, once we discuss, I wrote on the blackboard properties of division. I wrote on the blackboard. I will explain one after another. Children, with examples. Now you see, children, first one is what read? When a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. So that is the first property. Now on this property, let us take one example. See, children, here, suppose 78. Take the number example. 78. Divide this number with 1. Divide this number with 1. 78 by 1, how much, children? 78 only. Again, we get to 78. That means the quotient is the number itself. By after division, what we get? Quotient we get. Here, what is the quotient? The number itself. 78 only we got. This is the first problem. So, not only this number, any number you take and divide it by 1, then the quotient is the number itself. For example, one more example you take, children. Suppose 265. Divide this number with 1. Then again you can get 265 only. That's all now. That's why that is the first property. Now, come to second property. What is the second one? When 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0. That is the second one. So, now, example, let us take one example. Divide 0 with 69. Divide 0 with 69. Then the quotient is 0 only. 0 only again. That means 0 divided by 69 is equal to 0. According to the statement, when 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0. Here 0 is divided by what number? 68. Then what is the quotient? 0. You know actual division also, you know. See, children, here I show the actual division. Suppose 0 divided by 69. How many times? 0 times. In the table, with 0 starts the table. 7 zeros are 0, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 4, like that. So here, 69 zeros are 0. 69 zeros are 0. So, when 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0. One more example, you see. Divide 0 with 8,644. Any number you divide. Here what is divided? 0 is divided. By what number? 8,600. Again 0 only. So 0 divided by 0 is equal to
zero.
So when zero is divided by any number, the quotient is zero. Just like
that is the second property.
Now come to third property. When the number is divided by itself, the quotient is always one. The quotient is always one. So you take one number and divide it with itself. With itself. And you see what is the quotient. For example, you see here example. Take 45. Divide this 45 with 45 only. Divide 45 with 45. Then 45 divided by 45. How much? 1. 45 ones are 45. Actually, what is also one subject? 45. When 45 is divided by 45, 45 ones are 45. 0. So, 1 is the quotient. One is the, so, the quotient is always 1. Not only in this example, any example you can take. Suppose, one more example you see children here. Suppose, 264. Divide this with itself. Divide with itself. 264. 264 divided by 264. Then what you get? 1. 264 ones are 264. The quotient is always 1 only. Okay, understand. Okay, now you come to the fourth part. Division by 0 is not possible. Division by 0 is not possible. Okay. For example, you see here example. Take one number and divide by 0. 13 divided by 0. Not possible. Division by 0 is not defined. Division by 0 is not defined, undefined, not, we can't divide with 0, there is no division with 0. Okay, so here 13 by 0 in here in the brackets what we write, undefined. Division by 0 is meaningless. Okay, children, division by 0 is meaningless. That's why here not possible. Not possible. Possibility not there to divide with 0. There is no possibility. One more example, see children here. 9 divided by 0 is equal to here. Not possible. Not possible. Not possible. Divided by 0 is meaningless. Divided by 0 is meaningless. How can you divide with 0? No chance. So, divided by 0 not. Now, come to this problem. In division, the orders of numbers cannot be changed. Orders of numbers cannot be changed. For example, you see children, example, 10 divided by 5. 10 divided by 5. How much you get? If you divide 10 with 5, 0. 10 divided by 5 is 2. 10 divided by 5 is equal to 2. 5 2s are 10. See children here? 10 divided by 5. 5 2s are 10. Okay, children. Now, changing the order you take now. Change the order and take. See children here. First 5 you take. 5 divided by 10. 5 divided by 10. 5 divided by 10. 5 ones are 5. 5 2s are 5 by 10 means half. You can get half.
Are the same? Question is not same. 10 divided by 5 is equal to 2, but 5 divided by 10 is equal to half. Here, what you write? But 5 divided by 10 is equal to 1 by 10.
So, what you can understand here, 10 divided by 5 not equal to, is not equal to 5 divided by 10.
In 10 divided by 5, you get 2. 5 2s are 10. But by changing the order of the numbers, if you show the division, then you will get 1 by 2. How much? 1 by 2. I showed the number 5 by 10. 5 divides 5 one time, 5 divides 10 two times. How much you got? 1 by 2. So, children, here we are getting the different result. That's why 10 divided by 5 is not equal to 5 divided by 10. So, we can say that from this example, we can say that the order of numbers cannot be changed in the division. Order cannot be changed in the division. Okay, children. Now, come to some important parts. What is this here? Division by 10. What is the point should be noted here? In the division by 10, what is the key point you should keep in your mind? The digit at one's place, becomes the remainder. Remaining will be quotient. Okay, children. For example, you see, children, here. Suppose, example, you see. 8 is 7. Take. Divided by 10. 87 divided by 10. In this division war, what is the quotient and what is the remainder? What he told, the digit at one's place. What is the one's place digit here? In the dividend 87, what is the one's place? 7. One's place digit is 7. It becomes remainder. So 7 is the remainder. Now, remaining will be quotient. Remaining digits. What here? What are the remaining digits? 7 remainder. What is the remaining digit? 8. 8 is the quotient. You can observe the actual division. See, children. See, divide 87 with 10. How many times? 10 divides how many times? 8 times. 8. 10 8s are 80. That's why you write 8 times. 8 tens are 8. What is the remainder? 7. 7 is the remainder. What is the quotient? 8 is the quotient. That means, what you can understand? The digit at one's place that is it at a once place becomes remainder. The remaining will be quotient. The remaining will be quotient. So here the digit at once place is 7. That's why 7 bits remain. 7 becomes remainder. And the remaining digit means here, what is the remaining digit? 8. 8 becomes quotient. That is division by 10. Okay, students. One more example you see. 837 divided by 10. In this, you write quotient and remainder. Okay, sir. What is the remainder? What is the quotient? In this division. Second, into the point unit. What is the digit at once place? What is the digit at once place? 7. 7 is the digit at once place. It becomes remainder. It becomes a remainder. So, here the digit at once place is 7. 7 becomes remainder. 7 becomes a remainder. What are the remaining digits? What are the remaining digits? 8 to 3. 8, the remaining digits goes for a quotient. So, 83. 83 is the quotient and remainder is 10. You can observe in the actual division very clearly you can see 837. 837. Divide this with 100. 108 times. 8 into 100. 8 into 100. Okay, children. 8 into 100. 800. 837. So, here 837. So, 800. 37 is the remainder. 37 is the 837 divided by 10 over now. 800 divided by 10, you see, not 100. See, children, 837. 830, one more example, by 10 only, 10 only one more example. 837 divided by 10. Divided by 10. 10 8s are 80. 10 8s are 80. 3 remainder. Now bring down 7. 10 3s are 30. 7 remainder. 83 is the quotient. 83 is the quotient. Remainder is 7. Understand? So, you should be careful while doing the division. 837 is divided by what number? 837 is divided by 10. First, how many times? 8 times. 10 8s are 83. Now, 7 is to be bring down. Then 37. 10 3s are 37. So, what is the quotient here? 83 is the quotient. This is quotient. 83 is the quotient. Remainder is 7. Okay, children, that is division by 10. Division by 10. So, in this digit in ones place, digit in a digit at ones place, what is the digit at ones place? 7. That goes to the remainder. What are the remaining digits? What are the remaining digits? 8 and 3. So, 83 becomes a quotient. Like this. This is the division process with 10. Now, division by 100. Come to this. Division by 100. Division by 100. In this, digits of ones and tens. digits in this digits of ones and tens places becomes the remainder. Rest, here rest means what? Remaining digits. Here I wrote R-E-S-T, rest means what? Rest means remaining. Rest of the digits we write as quotient. It has a quotient. For example, you see here, Quotient and remainder. What is the quotient? And what is the remainder? Okay, children. See, in the statement, digits of ones and tens becomes remainder. Digits of ones and tens. What is the ones plus digit? 5. What is the tens plus digit? 9. So, 95 is the remainder. 95 is the remainder. 95 is the remainder. Remaining digits, what are the remaining digits? 2 and 3. So, this is the quotient. 23 is the quotient. 23 is the quotient. Once observe the actual division, 2395 divided by 100. 100. First two times right. 2 into 100, 2. 39. You get 39. Now bring down 5. Bring down this 5. Now how many times? 3 times. 3 times. 300. What is the remainder, sir? 95. This is the remainder. This is. So, 23 is the quotient and remainder is 95. So, digits of ones and tens places becomes remainder and remaining digits we write as quotient. So, here ones digit 5, tens digit 9. So, 95 we are writing as remainder and the remaining digits are 2 and 3. So, 23 quotient. Now come to this last point. Division by 1000. So in this division bar, digits of hundreds, tens and ones becomes the remainder. Digits of hundreds, tens and ones becomes the remainder. Rest of the digits will be goes for a quotient. For example, you see children, I will give an example here. 89654 divided by 1000. Write the quotient and okay, sir. What is the quotient and the remainder? Very simple now. According to the statement, what I told you? Digits of 100. What is the 100 plus digit? 6. Next, digits of 10. What is the 10 plus digit? 5. Digits of 1s. 1s plus digit 2, 4. So, 6, 5, 4. 654. This is goes for the remainder, 654, we take it as remainder. What is the quotient to remaining digits? What are the remaining digits here? 8 to 9. 8 to 9 are the remaining digits. So, 89 we take it as a quotient. Look at children, quotient is 89. remainder is 654. Like this, we can observe the divisions with 10, 100, 1000, etc. Okay, students, you are understanding about all these points? Okay, children, now we can go to the exercise problem. Dear students, now we are entering into the exercise 3 in the chapter, third exercise. In the third exercise, some problems are there. Some problems are there. Let us study. First one, in the section A, some multiplication problems are there. So, in this multiplication problem, now take the sixth one first. Using the properties, you can use properties and some simple division facts. You can do the multiplication. Actual multiplication also you can do. And some some simple problems using the properties and division facts, we can do the multiplication. For example, you see children here, first one, 7920 into 8750. That means here, this is the 4 digit number, 7920. Second number also, 4 digit number, 8750. Here, how should we multiply? Easily you see. First year 7920. 7920. So we can write as 792 into 10. 792 into 10, 7920. Okay. Now into this one. 8750 can be written as 875 into 10. Into 10. Now, the two numbers write, you keep side by side, and 10 into 10 last you write. 792 into 875 into 10 into 10. 10 into 10, you see, 792 into 875. The two numbers I write side by side and the two tens I wrote last. 10 into 10. You know, 10 into 10 how much? 10 into 10. So, 792 into 875 into 10 tens are 100. 10 tens are 100. Now, you multiply 792 and 875. Multiply. And simply keep 2 zeros at the last. Multiply 792 and 875. And keep 2 zeros at the last. That is the process, easy process. Okay, children. Now, you see 792 into 875. 875. 792 into 875. Okay, na? Multiply. First of all, multiply. 5 2s are 10. 0. 1 keep in mind. 5 9s are 45 plus 1. 46. So, write 6 here. 4 is there. 5 7s are 35. 35 plus 4. 39. 3 children, 5 2s are 10. 0. 1 is there. 5 8s are 45 plus 1, 46. 6 to 4 is there. 5 7s are 35 plus 4, 30. With 5, multiply. Now, multiply with 7 now. 7 2s are how much children? 7 2s are 14. So, 4 you write here in the tens place. Okay, now? Because we are multiplying with the tens digits. With tens digits we are multiplying, no? That's why 7 2s are 14. Here, 4 we write in the tens. Units, no. So, 7 2s are 14, 4 1 is there. seven nines are 63. 63 plus 1, 64. 4 right here, 6 is there. Keep in mind 6. 7 sevens are 49.
49 plus 6, how much here? 49 plus 6. How much 49 plus 6? 55. With 7 over. Now multiply with 8. Multiply with 8.
Okay, children. 8 2s are 16. 8 2s are 16. So 6 right in the 100s. Why? Because we are multiplying the 100s. Okay, children. That's why here no number. Here also no. So 8 2s are 16. 6 right here. 1 is there. 1 is there. 8 nines are 72 plus 1. 73. 73. 3 right here. 7 is there. Keep in mind. 7 is there. 8 sevens are 56. 56 plus 7. 56 plus 7. How much? 56 plus 7, how much is 60? Right, 60. Okay, children. Now, yeah. Now, here 0. Here 6 plus 4, 10. 0, 1. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 4, 11. 11 plus 9, 20. 0, 2 is there to carry. Now, 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. So, write 3 here. 1 is there. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 5, 9. Here, 3. 792 into 875. Is equal to how much you got? Right here, product 693, the two number multiplication gives 693 three zeros into here 100. Into 100 is there. Now multiply with multiplication with 100. Very easy, I told one point what? If a number is multiplied with 100, then what we do? Simply we keep two zeros last at the side of that number. Last one. That means 693000. Now the two zeros you keep here. This is the multiplication procedure. Okay, children. Observe once again. See, the two numbers are to be multiplied. What I did here first, 7920 can be written as 792 into 10, and this number 875 into 10. The two numbers written side by side, and 10 into 10 written last. 10 into 10 means 100. That's why what it is here. We multiply the two numbers and after multiplication we give two zeros at the last. That's why I showed multiplication there. 792 into 875. I showed multiplication. Actual multiplication showed on the tape, on the in the rougher. I showed the multiplication. Into 100. How much you got here? 693000. Into here, what is there? 100. So, multiplication with 100, very easy, you know, simply we keep two zeros last at the end of the number. So, this is the process. Now, come to this children. What is this sum here? 6456 is to be multiplied with 5000. Is to be multiplied with 5000. How we multiply? You see, easy process what here? The 6456 into 5000 can be written as 5000 can be written as 5 into 1000. 5 into 1000. So, what you do? We multiply the two numbers. We multiply the two numbers. After that, with 1000. Okay, na? 6, 4, 5, 6 into 5, the two numbers you multiply. Okay, na? Into 5, into 1000. Now, the two numbers multiply. The two numbers multiply. How much? The two numbers multiplication gives how much? 6, 4, 5, 6 into 5. 6, 4, 5, 6 into 5. Multiply. So, 5, 6 are 30, 0, 3 is there, 3 keep in mind. 5, 5 are 25, 25 plus 3, how much 25 plus 3? 20. So, 8 you write here, 2 is there. 5, 4 are 20, 20 plus 2, 22, write 2 here, and 2 is there. 5, 6 are 30 plus 2, 32. Once again, 3, 0. 5, 6 are 30, 0, 3 is there, 5, 5 are 25 plus 2, 28, 8, 2 is there, 5, 4 are 20 plus 2, 22, here 2, 2 is there, 5, 6 are 30 plus 2, 30. Now multiply, okay, so 6456 is multiplied with 5. How much you got? 32,000, the two numbers multiplication gives 32,208 into what is there here? 1000. Into what is there? 1000. So, to multiply the two numbers, what we do here? At the side of this number, that means right ending, ending of the right side. So, simply we keep 3 zeros. So, 3, 2, 2, 8, 0, and 3 zeros you write. This is the answer. Okay, children. So, very simply, you can show the light. Okay, children. Lights. Now come to this question. 7005. Okay, now see, children. How should you multiply? So, 3205 is to be multiplied by 7005. So, 7005 can be written as 7000 plus 5. 7000 plus 5. 7005. To multiply easily, you can follow this procedure. Here the two numbers under the two numbers were combined by plus. 7000 plus 5. So, now you do one thing here. Multiply the two numbers with 3205. That means 7000, we should multiply 7000 with 3205. And we multiply 5 with 3205. That means here what we write 3205 into 7000. And this number also, 3205 into 5. Okay, na? That means the two numbers are here under plus. That's why we multiply the two numbers separately with 3205. This number also multiplied with 3205, and that number also is to be multiplied by 3205. If you break like this multiplication with here 7000 is and multiplication with 5 is you are very well with 5 table. Yes or no? Here what I told here 3205
7 into 1000, 7000 plus 3000, 205 into 5. 7000 means 7 into 1000. Multiplication with 1000, I told you process. Simply we keep the last three digits. That's why I wrote that. Okay, children. Now multiply with the 7, this number multiply with the 7 and keep 3 zeros last. You see, children, here multiply with 7. 3205 into 7. Into 7. 7 5s are 35. 7 5s are 35. Strike out 5. Here, right? 3 is there. 7 zeros are 0. So, here 3. 7 2s are 14. 4 right here. 1 is there. 7 3s are 21 plus 1, 20. See, children, 7 5s are 35. 5 here, 3 is there. 7 zeros are 0, that's why 3. 7 2s are 14. 4 I wrote here, 1 is there. 7 3s are 21 plus 1, 20. 22,435. Into 1000. Let's. Here what 3205 into 5. 3205. Multiply this number with 5. Okay, children. Now you see here in this multiplication. 5 5s are 25 now. So 5 right here. 2 is there. 5 zeros are 0. 2. 5 5s are 25. 5 2 is there. 5 zeros are 0 plus 2 here 2. 5 2s are 10. 0 right here. 1 is there. 5 3s are 15 plus 1 6. How much am I here? 1605. 3205 into 5. Here I showed multiplication. 3205 into 5. 16025. Now here you see. 2, 2, 4, 3, 5. Simply keep 3 zeros at the side of this number. Okay, number. Last simply we keep 3 zeros. Plus 16,000. Now add these two. So the addition. Show the addition. 2, 2, 4, 3, 5. 2, 2, 4, 3, 5. 3 zeros. 16025. 16025. Add. Plus. Add, children, see. 5, here 2, here 0, here 5 plus 6 is 11, 1 right here, 1 is 8, 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5, here 4, 2, 2. 2, 2, 4, 2, 2, that is, the answer is 2, 2, 4, 5, 1. 0 to 5. This is the answer. Like this, we can do the multiplications easily using the properties. Using the property. That's why very in the beginning, we studied about the properties of division and the properties of multiplication. We studied. With the help of the properties, we can do the multiplications easily. Okay, children? So, now we go to the next section.